Hello everyone and welcome to SSB Crack Exams. I'm Hemant and I'm here with discussions regarding the analysis of the general knowledge section of the Territorial Army examination. Territorial Army is for those candidates who are actually into the general jobs whichever they are doing, but they want to serve in the Indian Army. So you can be a part of the Indian Army and you can also be a part of the civilian services, and thereafter you can lead your life with a very proper scenario. Territorial Army is that pool of the officers which will be utilized whenever Army needs, and it is these officers who are also very very proud that we have to consider. So if you want to become a part of the Indian Army, but if in case your age cutoff has been crossed for the examinations like NDA, CDS and all, and if you want to become a part of the Indian Army even though by being a part of the civilian service, then Territorial Army is a proper choice for you. So here I will be giving you a proper amount of analysis. I hope so that you guys have already gone through with the various other section in analysis. So in this part I will be discussing about the general knowledge section of the Territorial Army 2021 examination, which is going to be conducted very very soon, and we have also known that the notification for this examination has already appeared. Okay, so I will discuss about what is actually the topic wise analysis, what are the different kinds of topics that are there in this particular section, and I will also give you a proper amount of strategy, the best strategy to understand and learn for this particular section and crack this examination and score more amount of marks for this exam as much as you want. And thereafter I will tell you, because this exam, this GK section is around of 50 marks, among this 50 marks how to score 40 plus marks is what I'm going to discuss in this particular section, right guys? So I hope so that everybody who's watching this, both males and females who want to become a part of the Territorial Army, will be very very inspired and they will have a proper amount of idea. Without wasting any time, please make sure that you are watching with this particular session until the end, and also please make sure that you are sharing and liking the session as much as you can. Okay, so let us start off guys, and before beginning I will give you a brief introduction about SSB Crack Exams. SSB Crack Exams is India's largest, most preferred online defense exams preparation portal, and we at SSB Crack Exams help serious defense aspirants crack their defense examinations, and we have many number of courses. You name a defense examination and we have a course launched for that. We will give you a proper amount of guidance on whichever examination you people are preparing for. Especially, we people have launched a Territorial Army course already long back, and TA course has many number of benefits for all the future budding officers who want to become a serious part of the Army. And here in the Territorial Army examination, we have a very proper amount of courses. If you go through with the list of the courses that we have, then we have Territorial Army exam 2021 to 22 overview. We will give you a proper amount of understanding about what actually the exam is, how is it conducted, when is it conducted, what are the different sections and what is it actually all about, and how many people are writing this examination, what is the success rate, and what are the pay benefits and all the other things will be discussed in that overview in the first section. Thereafter, we will give you about the notification and the exam dates, about the upcoming examination dates. Thereafter, I will also we will also discuss with you about the Territorial Army 2021 live sessions. Live sessions have already been started since long and they are still going on. Please go through with that. Already geography, history, polity sessions are already being completed, and as of now chemistry sessions have also started, physics sessions have also been completed. Do not waste any time. Even mathematics sessions are going on, English sessions are going on. Don't waste time because live sessions are already live. So go through with that. And thereafter, daily current affairs and defense updates is extremely crucial and important if you want to crack the TA examination. Okay, and on a daily format, current affairs are going on, and since few days, weekly defense updates are also going to be going on. And very soon tomorrow, I will also be discussing with you about the monthly defense current affairs for the month of July. So do not waste any time and make sure that you are watching all of those sessions so that you will also have a proper amount of understanding. Even after you cracking the examination, there will be many number of interviews that you have to tackle in further to become a permanent part and to become trained in that particular army. Okay, so all the details regarding that, it will be helpful if you are following these daily current affairs and the daily defense current affairs. Thereafter, we will also give you a section about separately about regarding the personality development and motivation. Then you will also be getting that reasoning section of the TA exam, mathematics Territorial Army exam, English session is also been completed. Then comes a static GK, history, polity, geography, biology, physics, chemistry and economics. All of these sessions have already been completed, and we are also updating many number of new lectures on a day-to-day format. Do not waste time and subscribe. Do not forget to use the code WARRIOR10 to get an extra 10% discount off on all of our courses. Do not forget to use this code and become a part of this particular vibrant, growing SSB career exams team of the budding future Army, Navy and Air Force officers. I hope, sir, that you people will crack the upcoming Territorial Army examination with proper amount of distinctive analysis after you preparing very well with us. Right, guys? First and foremost thing, let us start off and go through with the content. First and foremost thing, I'll give you a subject-wise analysis. Remember, Territorial Army has around 200 questions, and from all of that, 50 questions are asked from the elementary mathematics, 50 questions are from reasoning, 50 questions are from general knowledge, and 50 questions are from English. Okay, so already Anuradha ma'am has already discussed about the English session. You will also be getting the updates regarding the elementary mathematics and reasoning from Drishti ma'am, but my focus will be on the general knowledge of these 50 questions. So I will be focusing about what kind of questions will be coming here and what are the topics, and since previous years how many questions have come from each and every particular subject and how much importance should you give to that particular subject also I will be discussing in this particular session. Right, guys? Starting off regarding the very important thing, important regarding the marking scheme, for all of the sessions you will have the same marking scheme. Remember, total marks of this examination is 200 marks and you have 200 questions. It gives a clear understanding that for every correct answer you will be given one mark. Okay, one mark for every correct answer, and for every incorrect answer you will be deducted or you will be minus cutting it. You will be deducted around 0.33 marks for every incorrect answer. Okay, and let us go through in detail regarding the subjects that we have, the components of the Territorial Army General Knowledge Syllabus. And we have these important subjects, guys. We have the subjects of physics, chemistry, biology, geography, history, polity, economics, static GK, current affairs and defense specific. Very simply, we can divide this whole country into three parts. The first three will be coming under the general science, okay, which will be discussed, okay, which is physics, chemistry and biology. Then geography, history, polity and economics will be coming under the humanities part, okay. So in the humanities you need to give a little bit more importance, and thereafter in the static GK and current affairs, it is simply known as the static GK and current affairs. Okay, so these are something more important. You can divide it into three different parts, but I will tell you in the end, after going through with the all the previous year content and analysis, you will be having a proper amount of idea about which particular subject should you focus more and which particular subject should you focus a little bit less. And is there any other scoring strategies? Is there any other important ideas? And how many questions actually came from each and every particular topic since the year of 2016 and all, I will be discussing in this session. Right, guys? So make sure that you are subscribing to us. And as I already told you, all of these subjects are already given from our side. I'm again reiterating because this whole content is already covered from our side and we are also updating on a day-to-day format. Become a part of SSB Creek Exams growing team. Okay? So going through forward, guys, let us start off without wasting any time regarding the physics, Territorial Army's general knowledge, previous year's question and answers analysis. The number of questions in the physics part have been reducing in the since the previous years, if you have to consider. Remember, in 2018, Territorial Army paper exam was not conducted. So from all of these, from upcoming from now until the session ends, wherever I'm showing the bar graph of the 2018, the bar of 2018 will be empty, indicating that either the questions have not been asked or the exam has not been conducted. But the real reason is that in 2018 exam has not yet been conducted. Okay, so we have to understand that in the 2016 there were 6 questions out of 50 coming from this whole GK paper in the GK section of the Territorial Army exam, but thereafter in 2017 only 2 questions came, and thereafter in the very recent year of 2019 only 1 question came. And even in 2020, TA exam was not conducted. It was because of the pandemic. Hope so that this time exam will be conducted as much better as possible. And also it gives a clear understanding, guys, very serious Territorial Army aspirants. Please do follow COVID-19 for related norms and regulations. Do educate your people from around yourself and always in the social media that they follow the COVID-19 related protocol and norms so that you people don't get your exams postponed and you will write the exams with flying colors, right? So as I told you, physics content, the questions have been reducing and we have no idea. There might be a possibility in TA 2021 exam you might not expect any question, or there might also be a possibility that you might expect again many number of questions. So as far as the formulas that we go through, the average number of questions that will be asked in the upcoming Territorial Army 2021 examination will be around 2 to 3, guys. Okay, it will be around 2 to 3. Very simply, you will be scoring around 2 to 3 marks if you gain a proper amount of knowledge regarding this one. Okay, and the physics content is already covered, so I will be giving you a proper amount of analysis about which particular chapters you should mainly focus upon so that you can get many number of marks. You will be able to score all the physics questions in this examination. Going through now towards the chemistry section, guys, and the chemistry section has been maintaining a proper amount of weightage, if I have to say. There were 6 questions in 2016 regarding the chemistry. There were 3 questions in 2017, 2018 no paper conducted, but there were 5 questions in 2019. The number of questions was very large, then it reduced and then it is increasing. So we cannot say about the next upcoming paper, but we can imagine and we can calculate with the formulas that we have regarding the average number of questions that might be asked in the upcoming exam, and the correct answer for that particular one would be around 4 to 5 questions, guys. Okay, you can expect around 4 to 5 questions in the chemistry of the GK paper in the upcoming TA examination. Moving on now towards the biology section, again this is also following the almost a similar trend like physics, I have to say, because there were 9 questions, too many number of questions they were asked. Around, let's say, approximately around 1/5 of the paper was of biology questions only in the year of 2016, but that number reduced to number 3 in 2017, and then again it reduced to number 2 in 2019. And going through with the similar amount of analysis that we are considering, I can say that we can expect from around 4 to 5 questions in the upcoming TA 2021 examination, and by scoring them all properly, you will be able to score 4 to 5 marks out of these 50 marks. Okay, moving on forward with the next important one. Before going through, I would also like to tell you regarding the Territorial Army balance section. I hope so that you guys have already known about Vibhav sir taking the chemistry live classes. If you have not yet known, please go through with that, because the lectures are very, very beautiful, and most of the number of candidates have joined our courses after listening to Vibhav sir's lectures, especially in the same format. We also have a separate tutor for biology known as Brinda ma'am, and Brinda ma'am is also very, very nice, good expert in teaching biology, and she also has an experience in interacting with the students. And we have the content for the biology also in the similar format. Physics content is also being covered, and the similar format other subjects content is also covered. Make sure that you are joining us so that your preparation strategies and level are all up to the mark, and you will be able to crack the upcoming examination with flying colors. Moving on with the next most important content is regarding the geography, and we have to understand that geography is very, very important, and in the recent examination itself, the questions have boosted up around 1/5 of the paper. Long back in 2016, only 6 questions were asked, and the same number of questions were asked in 2017, but in the recent question paper of 2019, 10 questions were asked. That gives a clear understanding that you cannot take geography for granted. Okay. So already in TA 2021 live sessions, in the conceptual part, I've discussed about the Indian geography, world geography, physical geography concepts, and thereafter I've also discussed about the important number of MCQ questions that were asked in the recent examination patterns and all. And you can follow with that, and thereafter, if you are following our Territorial Army taking our course, then geography TA course has many number of updated content in detail regarding the explanations. You can join that and you can gain knowledge with much more knowledge. Okay, so going through with this analysis, I can say that we can expect from around average around 7 to 8 questions in the upcoming TA examination. So you cannot take GK, you cannot take geography content for granted, guys. Okay, moving on, after geography, the next humanities topic will be history. And history also is very, very important. It is equally important as geography, guys. There were 9 questions asked in 2016, 10 were asked in 2017, and then again 7 were asked in 2019. There might be a possibility and chances the number of questions in the upcoming paper might boost up. So you cannot take even history for granted. So going through with this trends and analysis of the previous years, we can say that we can expect from around 8 to 9 questions in the upcoming TA paper. And by scoring all of them correctly, obviously you will be able to score 8 to 9 marks in the upcoming TA examination, around approximately 1/5 of the paper, right? Moving on with the next humanities subject will be polity. And if you are going through with the polity, they were very less. But you can see in the TA exam, it is exactly following opposite trends until now. And it is extremely important, because the number of questions in polity is increasing with paper, with year by year. There was only 1 question in 2016, but then again it became 3 in 2017, and then again it became 6 in 2019. There might be a possibility this number might increase, so you cannot take even this section for granted. Okay, going through with the average marks and the formula that we follow, we will be able to score around 3 to 4 marks out of 50 marks if you are focusing on this one. That means a clear indication that you will be getting around 3 to 4 questions in the upcoming examination. But there is a possibility the number might cross 10, but you should not take this content for granted, guys. And as I already told you, the previous year's questions of the politics section have already been covered from our side. So how we approach is that first and foremost, we go through with the politics section. Every particular subject, we'll go through with its previous year's questions, and thereafter we will give them a proper amount of understanding about what all are the topics and what kind of questions are being asked from that particular subject. After, a student will gain a proper amount of understanding about how that subject is. Thereafter, he will go through with the conceptual lectures, then he will go through with the study material, and then again he will go through with the sample practice questions, then the study material of those sample practice questions, then quizzes, and then again practice exercises. So what happens is, with the same amount of concept, is going through with many number of reiterations that will make his content much more brighter, better and beautiful. Okay, moving on with the next most important content is regarding economics. And okay, we can't take economics also for granted, but this also has the same level of importance. As I can say, there was no question asked. There were absolutely zero questions asked in 2016 paper. Okay, so there were only zero questions asked in the 2016 paper, and there was only one question asked in 2017, and there were four questions asked in the year of 2019. Going through with this previous year trends and analysis, I can say we can expect from around only 1 to 2 questions in the economics part. So it depends on yourself whether you want to give an importance towards economics or not. If you do have time, please do study economics. But if in case you do not have time, I personally do tell you that you can omit it. But as a tutor, it is not my duty to tell you that you can simply leave economics. You should take time to learn even that, because even one mark changes a lot. And in TA, the competition level is extremely high. It's very, very high. And you know regarding that. So the number of officers who get selected in the territorial army every year will be very, very low. That gives a clear understanding you cannot miss even one single mark. So you should focus on economics also. Moving on with the next important subject will be the static GK. This is considered to be the top notch important subject of all the subjects that I have covered. So what is the difference between static GK and current affairs? Current affairs is the dynamic general knowledge, but static GK is a static general knowledge. Like for example, if I have to say the first mountaineer who climbed Mount Everest, the first person to become the president of India, the first female president of India, the first president of USA, the first person to go through and climb all the 7 highest mountain peaks in all the continents. So all of these are static ones, they don't change. Okay, so those that do not change is known as a static general knowledge. But if I case, if I'm discussing about the current affairs, then who is the current IT minister, the current minister of defense, and if I'm discussing about what is happening regarding the current exercises, so all of these things are considered to be the dynamic GK. So what I'm trying to discuss is about the static GK. Okay, and static GK considers many number of concepts like Indian panorama, world panorama, the first, highest, tallest, smallest, shortest and all, and thereafter the old things that are going on, and the current ministers, state governments and all, and different kinds of national parks, and all of these things will be coming under the static GK. You can go through with the content that we already have. You can download SSB Crack Exams learning app, and then you can check about what actually are the topics in the static GK. And going through with this content, guys, with the previous year patterns, there were around 8 questions asked in the static GK, but the question actually doubled up. It actually rose up, boosted up. In the year of 2017, there were 16 questions, and then again it again slowly reduced to around 10 questions in 2019. So it clearly indicates that you cannot take static GK for granted. Going through with this particular analysis, I can say you can expect from around 10 to 11 questions in the upcoming examination. So do not miss any chance to study the static GK. You cannot take this subject for granted. Okay, moving on with the next most important subject is regarding the current affairs, guys. And the current affairs is also very, very important, actually equally important as much as economics. So even one mark is also very, very important for us. There was only one question asked in 2016 regarding the current affairs that were going on, but the number rose to around 4 questions in 2017, and then again it reduced to around 3 questions in 2019. Going through with this previous year's trends and analysis, I can see we can expect from around 1 to 2 questions in the upcoming TA 2021 examination. So the whole content is already being covered, guys, and you will be getting many number of static GK content, especially in important exercises, military exercises and all, they have already been covered. It is a mixture of both the defense specific related questions and all, but you can go through with the whole content about what is actually happening, the timeline of the Indian Air Chief Marshals, Army Generals, Indian Navy commanders, and all the important issues, the squadrons that we have, and what are the important issues that are going on, defense acquisitions, deals, international organizations like UNESCO, UNO, and even many number of organizations that are going on. Let it be Association of Southeast Asian Nations, the content regarding that, even BRICS content regarding that, and NATO, North Atlantic Treaty Organization content regarding that, then World Trade Organization, World Bank, even many number of important multinational bodies are there, and many number of reports are also released, World Human Trafficking Report, or also Corruption Report, and GDP Report, many number of types of different things are also going on. So all of these will be considered under the strategy KPAR. You can go through with that, and it will be very, very important for all of you. Okay, moving on towards the defense specific questions, guys, there were many number of, always do make sure that you are following the defense current affairs being provided by specific exams, especially for the TA aspirant. This is actually a no-go. Okay, so always make sure that you are going through with the defense current affairs. The number of questions were 4 in 2016, 2 in 2017, and 2 in 2019. Very clearly, you can say you can expect from around 1 to 2 questions in the upcoming TA 2021 examination. Okay, so that's all I've discussed. All important subjects I've discussed about physics, chemistry, biology. Then I've discussed about geography, history, economics, and polity. And then also I've discussed about the SATing GK and current affairs. And also I've discussed about the content regarding the defense specific ones. So in the end, I would like to tell you about the consolidated general knowledge previous years Q&D analysis. Going through with this one, you can say there were around 16% of the paper will be coming from geography. That means it indicates around 8 questions. 18% will be coming from history, it indicates around 9 questions. Polity will be 8%, it indicates around 4 questions. Economics will be 2%, it indicates around 1 question. Static GK will be 22%, it indicates around 11 questions. Current affairs will be 4%, will be indicating around 2 questions. Defense specific also 4%, which indicates 2 questions. Physics will be 6%, which indicates 3 questions. Chemistry will be 10%, which indicates around 5 questions. And thereafter, biology will also be 10%, which indicates around 5 questions. If you add all of these 8 plus 9 plus 4 plus 1 plus 11 plus 2 plus 2 plus 3 plus 5 plus 5, approximately, I think if it will be exactly equal to around 50 questions. So this is the equal amount of weightage. So going through with this particular one, you will be getting a very nice analysis, guys. You can see the maximum number of pie chart is actually covered by the static GK as number 1, and thereafter history will be number 2 and geography will be number 3. Okay, thereafter number 4 sections will be the biology. Okay, then comes chemistry, and then comes polity. Okay, so this will be number 6 one, and thereafter number 7 one will be physics. Okay, then after physics, you can again focus upon the defense specific ones, then static current affairs ones, and thereafter you can also focus upon the economics one. Economics is the least important, but thereafter it is your choice whether to touch it or not, as I told you. So this is what that you guys have to remember. Please do not waste time and join SSB Connect Exams online course. And we have also launched a mock test series, guys, and after going through with each and every particular mock test, you can say this is a basic understanding. This is a quiz report of the Indus Valley Civilization. So a student has completed an Indus Valley Civilization lecture and thereafter is attempting the quiz and fortunately got all of the questions correctly. Okay, so around 10 questions he answered all the 10 correctly, so he'll get a proper analysis about how much time did he spend, about the time analysis, the total amount of time he has taken, the score analysis, and whether to compare with other students or not, what is his overall all India level of competency levels. So it is a very consolidated report. So after each and every particular quiz, every short and small quiz also you attend from our side, you will get a consolidated report about how much stronger are you on that particular topic. Okay, go through with that. And as I already told you, the most important topics for the territorial army, I'm reiterating, they are static GK, geography, history, physics, chemistry, biology, and polity. Others ones you can give it as a next important priority. These are the topics of the 4 most priority, and the next most important priority might be given towards the current affairs. Okay, so next priority might be given towards the current affairs, then defense specific, and thereafter you can also give it a go for the economics. Okay, so 4, 7 and 3, around 10 important topics are there, you can go through with that. So these are those things that you can give it as a least important, but the maximum importance should be focused upon the static GK. But sir, why do you say up to go through with the daily current affairs and the daily defense updates if in case current affairs is very low important? Actually, we are going through with the daily current affairs and defense updates, we are not not only discussing the basic current affairs, we are also discussing the static general knowledge questions also in the current affairs. So it is a mixture of both of them. It is a holistic approach. Okay, go through with that and you will gain a proper amount of understanding. Okay, so if you want to learn static GK, then also current affairs will be extremely important for all of you. Okay, moving on, the strategies regarding to Godhra, as I told you I'll give you a brief analysis about this particular examination, then I'll tell you I will be discussing about the best strategy and how to score 40 plus marks. Here is the strategy, guys. You can get about an updated content of all of this portion either from SSB Crack books or from the SSB Crack Exams Territory Lamy online course 2021-22. This is actually the only way I personally suggest, because for you people to again buy XYZ books and then again sit again for hundreds of hours and thereafter getting nothing out of it, and thereafter even if you learn, you might not be confident whether your subject, whether you have learned a proper amount of examination or not, and you will not be confident enough whether your knowledge is enough for that or not. But if you are joining our course, I'll give you a proper amount of understanding whether that knowledge is important or not, and what to study, what not to study, how to approach, and the different tricks and tips to crack the examination will also be discussed in our course. Join us. I will personally guide you. Even not only me, even Anuradha ma'am, Drishti ma'am, Brinda ma'am, and also Bibab sir will be personally guiding you people, so that you will be attaining proper amount of goals. Even Zaheer sir is also going through. He will be discussing most important topics regarding history and other humanities related subjects. So you can join us. We will personally guide you. Okay, so the more number of mock tests you do, the more you are prepared for the examination. Along with the original online Territorial Army course, please do take TA mock test series also. They are very very less when compared to the cost of the original course. So the cost of this mock test series is very less. You can take it as a bulk and we can give you more discount if you are interested with that. But do make sure that you are taking this mock test series also, which make your content preparation much more stronger. So why do I tell you to take this mock test series? Because we have the questions that are cross-checked, analyzed, detailed and arranged as per the latest exam patterns that boosts the toughness of the questions and assures the candidates self-study and revision in a holistic manner. Moving on forward, guys, always make sure that you are noting notes in a separate dedicated preparation notebook. Okay, it is not like you took any kind of paper and then after writing in it and then after you're throwing that paper. It should not be like that. Make a proper amount of notes whatever you're writing, and do maintain the decency level, do maintain the level of dedication, discipline. Only then you will be able to crack the examination. It will be your primary guiding document for ensuring success, guys. No matter how many number of PDFs you take from us, you learn, listen to all of us, but in the end you should make sure that jo bhi notes aap logon ne likha, wo hi aap logon ko sabse zyada help karega. Okay, so to write proper amount of notes, you need to have proper amount of content, and to have a proper amount of content, you need to be a part of SSB Crack exams. Okay, so always go through with the main concepts. Do not try to solve any lengthy numerical problems. Almost everything in this section is purely theoretical. Please do remember, this is not mathematics or reasoning section. You will not get any kind of maximum, many detailed numericals and all. Even if you're getting numericals, they will be very small and short. I will discuss with you about how much tough are those numericals or how easy are those. Join us, I will tell you. So do not try to solve lengthy numerical problems. Most of this content will be around 90 to 99% of this content will be only theoretical part. Please do keep that in mind and make sure that you religiously follow this plan so that it will be helpful for you. And you can follow us and get back to us at support@ssbcrackexams.com if you are facing any other problems or are having any kind of ambiguity. Okay, join us and become a part of SSB Crack Exams, because we are India's largest, most preferred online defense exams preparation portal. Choose any one of your courses. If you're preparing for any other defense examination, we have the courses launched for that also. Become a part of us. And as I already told you, we have the content launched for the Territorial Army's notification, live sessions, current affairs and defense updates, personality development and motivation, reasoning, mathematics, English sections are also completed, static GK, history, polity, geography, biology, physics, chemistry and economics. You see, you name any kind of subject, we have a content already ready for all of that. So become a part of us, and please please guys, do not forget to use the code Warrior10 to get an extra 10% discount off on all of our courses. So that's all for this particular session, guys. And I hope so that you people are all maintaining COVID-19 related safety norms and regulations. The time for the upcoming examination for TA 2021 exam is very, very less. And it is very crucial and important. The more faster you join, the more better your selection chances will be. The more better you will be able to score in the upcoming examination. Become a part of us and join as soon as possible. And please do follow COVID safety related norms and regulations. Stay at home, stay safe, and always keep smiling. Be confident. Jai Hind.